Guess what, everybody? Today is Tuesday morning. It is 5 of 9, and I am 55 years old. No, today is not my birthday. But it will be the very first time in my life that I say, give me my senior citizen discount. And I'm looking forward to it. I don't know if they'll let me film or not. It would kind of be funny. But you know what? It's already happened. I mean, it happened like 2 or 3 years ago. Would you like your senior citizen discount? I'm not 55 yet. Oh well. What is it, 15% on Tuesdays? Watch me not find anything and I can't get my discount. I'm gonna buy something anyway, even if it's just a new hat. Y'all, everybody's tired of seeing me in that ratty old hat. Not this one, but the other one with the rips in it. Okay, let's go see what we can find. My senior citizen self.
Well, the objects made by the Porcelier Company just have a certain quality. And sure enough, you handle a few pieces and you don't even have to turn it upside down, but it's almost always marked, but not always. So here's Porcelier. You saw the word China. That's not made in China, but it's porcelain China. It's a United States company, US company that made light fixtures and all kinds of things out of porcelain in the 30s and 40s. This is nice. It's English, and I didn't necessarily see the bowl to match it. This would have gone on a wash stand. Look at that there. There's a patent date and everything. $13.99 isn't bad for a great big old pitcher like that, but golly, talk about obsolete and out of style. This is a tough sell. Oh, old romper room. Mm-hmm. Miss Nancy, she didn't ever see me in the magic mirror. No, she didn't see me. What year is that? Oh, made in Jersey City. And let's see here. Well, we all know what that is. Let's turn it upside down and see what the price is. I'm at a thrift shop in Pennsylvania. Let's see here. Ooh, $20 in a thrift shop. No. I can't do that. It's a little expensive there, Mr. Thrift Shop. That thing looked like it was a powder jar, maybe from the Depression, but it's missing a lid. And little golf pro thing there that you hang in your window. What do you call those things? Not color form. What do you call that thing? I don't remember. Let's see, crackle glass, that's cute. Ooh, $10 for that little thing? Heavens, put it down. Ooh, I don't know who was pricing that day. Here's some pretend Majolica. It just looks, turn it upside down, look, it's brand new. It's flat, it has no depth, it has no, you just know, you can just look at it and see. I'm not very good with my adjectives today. Oops. And let's see here. Oh, that's, I don't know. $5. No, I didn't buy that. It was okay. I don't know. Boy, in this store, it's all a mumble jumble. I mean, everything. Oh, I love the deco handle on the top of that thing, but that lid, I think it was a marriage. That lid didn't match that. Something was funny about it. Oh, the little silver overlay stuff. Oh, that's pretty, a compote for cheese. Wow, look at that. It's Depression era. Elegant etched. That's a pretty etching. I don't recognize it. That's not bad, $3.99, but you can see there's just so much. I mean, if I bought everything, oh my word, I'd have to come home with two truckloads. A cream soup, that's pretty. English again. Very quaint. And, no, those aren't jade oaks.
Somebody murdered this 1920s Second Empire or Empire style table. It's, well, it dates to about 1915 to 1925. It's got the scroll feet here. This would be called Empire. It's probably mahogany under there. They usually are. Someone has painted it black, but even worse, they cut the back off of it so it would fit up against a wall. That's a 100-year-old table that's been destroyed.
I run into little, pretty little porcelain pieces like this quite often, sometimes hand-painted and sometimes just with decals. Oh, look there. Is that Martha? Was a handsome woman, wasn't she? How much was that? $5, made in Germany. With some, probably the 1930s when they had the, I can never remember, what is it? The something, 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 when they were celebrating the Washingtons in the early 30s. You guys, someone will remind me of what I'm trying to think of. It was some kind of Washington anniversary in the early 30s. But I don't remember what it was. Maybe the centennial of his birth, that's possible, I guess. If he was born in the 17, no, the bison, never mind, I can't remember. Okay. Let's see, spin it around, turn around, every now and then. I don't find anything. Hold on to your wallet. Don't spend your money, you'll regret it. That's true. It's hard, though, because you feel almost like a failure, you know, like you failed for the day, but you haven't failed for the day. If you come home with as much money in your wallet as when you left the house, that's okay, my fellow thrifters. That was pretty. I know the pricing scheme there. They use Roman numerals in case the price tag falls off or in case somebody tries to switch it. But I wasn't sure what to do with that one piece. I guess it was probably a milk pitcher rather than a creamer. Oh, this is cute. And not the Gerber baby, but I did read that the model for the Gerber baby passed away not just, oh, I don't know, a couple months ago. But this is something else. This is 1935. Okay, I like that. Let's see, to Elsie Louise Foley, I can't read it, with love from somebody, November the 2nd, 1942, $10, charming, but I don't know that really it had any resale value. Now, do not be fooled. You do not have to pick that up. You don't have to flash your black light on that. Because nothing like that was ever made in the 1930s. And you see, made in China. It's pretty, though. Nothing wrong with it. It's just a new item. And I don't buy and sell new items, as you know, as a general rule. So I left it there. But it's perfectly good piece of glass, pretty piece, and functional, and probably would have sold online for $20 or so. Oh, what has he got in his cart? He better show us. I think he will. I was admiring this. It's clear, it's old. And it's a swan vase that had a pressed pattern in it. You can see, I was looking maybe for a Mark Imperial or somebody. But you can see there where it's definitely one of those old swan vases, probably from about 1915 to 1920, 25, something like that. $3, not bad. Look at the thistle. See it? On that little cream pitcher. So many wonderful pieces of pattern glass to study. Oh, I bought these. These little lotus leaf candle holders, $5. They're going to be nice with orange candles in them in the autumn season. So even though you see me put it back on the shelf, it does wind up in my cart. In fact, I'm looking at it right now. It's on the windowsill. I'm at home doing a voiceover because the jams were pumping in the store. Who made this, my mid-century friends? Is it Viking or L.E. Smith? I am so not good, so not conversant with my mid-century glass, but I see a piece of silver crest. Woohoo! That's right, Fenton. Get a hold of that. That's a big 13-inch post-war Silvercrest Fenton piece, but pre-1970 because it's not marked. That bad boy's going in the cart. They sell for 35, 40 bucks. And take a look at this. I bought this as well. I'm not doing a whole lot with tidbits, but that sounded funny. I'm not doing a whole lot with tidbit trays, but I really liked the handle on this. It's a good one. And you see the squared off, the cut off, beveled off edges were right in the 1930s. Fenton had a pattern like that. L.E. Smith had a pattern like that.
This is a great example of a tricky piece of glass. Now, if you do a picture reverse search or whatever it's called, or a Google search, you will almost always come up with Viking. But we've seen this before in the old curiosity shop. And we've also seen it in the 1920s and 30s glass book, where the original mold was made by the Beaumont Glass Company from the 20s and 30s. And then Viking also put something like this out much later, 20, 30 years later. Sometimes there was a flower frog that sat. Oh, I guess I'm not in the picture. Sorry about that. Sometimes there's a flower frog that sits on the top. There are very slight differences between the early 1920s Beaumont piece and the glass that that Viking made. The colors are different. There's something different with the legs and the mold, but they look almost identical. And I can't tell you which one this is because you really have to have measurements and study it closely, and I don't have those colors or measurements memorized. But it's $3.99, and I may or may not buy it. I haven't decided yet. It's a cute little thing. I suppose I might just go ahead and get that. Here's a nice candlewick vase, which actually has an etched pattern on it. Can you see that there through all the dirt and grime? This looks like the kind of damage that will come off, but as I've said before, and as you know, if you've collected glass, there's a difference between calcium deposits and true sick glass. Some of it is curable and some of it is not. And it's very difficult to tell out in the wild whether it's going to be able to be cleaned or not. So you are usually taking a chance when you find a piece of sick glass or glass that's dirty like this, because it may or may not become crystal clear again. Okay, $6 on that. I'd like to do a whole video on that. You know, the difference between glass that you can clean and glass that you can't. Okay, let me show you a couple of things before I go inside, but I'm certainly not gonna sit in this sweltering truck very long. It's hot. This might be a piece of junk. Well, it's not a piece of junk. It just might not be anything special. I'm gonna show it to you. I haven't done any research yet. So here it is. It's a really beautiful frog. It is a really beautiful frosted glass vase with, I think that's called an iris, but I don't know. And it's, the irises have been given a purple tint. Can you see the purple tint? There's no damage to this vase. And I turned it upside down, which I'm going to do now. And I want you to notice here on the rim, which is what sits on the table, you can see that this, I don't know that you can see, I can see, this is polished glass. So this was made in a mold. I can see where it was in a mold, but then the bottom of it was polished, which means it's, okay. And then look at all of the wear. There's a tremendous amount of scratching and sort of natural wear on. This would be, if this were new, this would be completely shiny as that. But this almost looks frosted. It's not frosted, but it's been scraped around on a table for a while. So I've got to go and see. There's something about this. I didn't pay much for it. And if it turns out to be something that was sold at Walmart yesterday, I will, don't know what I'll do, but I'm going to sell it. It's just that I'm going to do some more research on it. So anybody with any ideas? Wonderful. I just think it's really nice, really pretty piece. And then the other two pieces I know are old. This I'm going to put with my Cambridge, with my, this is the Cambridge amethyst and the chrome craft, right? We've all seen these. So I'm putting together a nice collection of this. I've got shot glasses and tumble, and I've got, I'm not thinking straight. What else have I got? I just have a whole bunch of this. I think the heat is getting to them too. So that's nice. And then I apologize if I'm lackluster. I've been running around. This is antique. And it's a good one. And it's going to be for sale. I've got to clean it. Now you will recognize good glass from the 1920s. This is good department store glass. This is not the cheap stuff that was given away for free. So look at the hand-painted enamel on here. Many companies did this kind of work. Lancaster glass, US glass. On and on and on. And I only named two. But it's just, really it's a vase. A small vase. And it's wonderful. See what I paid? I am not afraid to pay for a good piece of glass. And that's, wait until I get that cleaned up and ready. I also have a magnificent coffee percolator, and I mean magnificent, with cream and sugar back here, but I've got to get it inside and get it cleaned. Let's go inside.
Today I also bought an original oil painting of Mary and Jesus. Now this is quite old. You can just tell it's at least 100 years old. It's got a little bit of damage, which doesn't bother me. And I think it's beautifully done. Of course, I know a lot of people feel very differently about religious artwork. And it's almost, well, it's a certainty that Mary and Jesus didn't look like this. Very European. But of course, that's the way they were depicted in those days. And it's just beautifully done. It's not signed or dated or anything. And there is a rip here. And there's a puncture here and some loss and another little. Really doesn't bother me. It was, what, $5.99 for this original oil. And you turn it over to the back. Someone has put this old particle board thing on here. I forget, what is this thing called? Anyway, and so, but look at the way the frame is done, the canvas, and the way it's held in place. This is the old-fashioned way of doing it. So, very nice. And I'm seeing now there's some type of a label under here. So, I hadn't noticed that before. Let's turn it and see if we can see. I see something Philadelphia Chestnut Street. What does it say? You probably can see we have a Chestnut Street. I'm gonna have to take this off and just see. Of course, that might just be the label from the frame company. I don't know. Didn't get far enough. But anyway, very nicely done. And even if it's something that a person didn't hang, put up year round, wouldn't that be a beautiful thing to bring out at Christmas time, to be part of your Christmas decorations for those who celebrate the birth of Christ at Christmas time? That would be really nice, I think. So, I'm happy with that.